All right, breaking news coming in. In fact, a plea filed by CBI's number two Rakesh Asthana in the Delhi High Court. The advocate for Mr. Asthana have said that status quo must be maintained. Delhi High Court asked CBI to not disturb the equilibrium today. Delhi Court High Court directs Rakesh Asthana and Devinder Kumar to ensure safe custody of all evidence, electronic items, phones, laptops, etc. in their possession. CBI asked 1 day's time to, in fact, amend the FIR, bring on record all sections against the accused. Let me go across to my colleague Munish Pandey, who is joining me for more on this story. Munish, how do you see this? Is this interim relief, a breather for Rakesh Asthana?
Yeah, well, we can say that he cannot be arrested till this Monday, that is October 29. Till October 29, he cannot be arrested according to Delhi High Court's direction. But also remember, Delhi High Court has also said that we have to see at the gravity of this case. Now, the allegation was that the case has been filed under Section 7A of Corruption of Prevention Act, and Asthana says that it should be under Section 17A of Corruption of Prevention Act, for which there has to be sanction from the government. But Delhi High Court says said that you have to look at the gravity of the allegations made against the made against you and Devinder Kumar. And Asthana also, through his lawyer, said that this case has been filed against two senior officials of Central Bureau of Investigation after a complaint from one person. There are malafide intention, to which Delhi High Court says that we can't say as of now that there is any malafide intention, but we have to look at the gravity. As of now, you hand over all the electronic evidences, phones and laptops for the investigation, and they have also directed the Central Bureau of Investigation to bring all the all the sections in this case before the court. Now, what we are hearing from the Central Bureau of Investigation, that apart from the charges of bribery and Prevention of Corruption Act, they will also bring the section of extortion in this case. And remember, Ankit, even the Patiala House Court observed that there is an extortion racket which is running in the Central Bureau of Investigation, and for which there has to be a fair investigation by the agencies.
Munish, you know, at this point of time, what happens to the other senior officer, the deputy SP, who was in fact taken in custody yesterday by the CBI?
Yeah, well, for Ankit, for that, we have to wait for the Patiala House Court order, which is expected around 4 o'clock. The order is reserved. The court has heard both the sides, where Devendra Kumar alleged that this case has been made against Rakesh Asthana, and he is only being made scapegoat in this case, whereas CBI says that he fabricated this statement to frame the CBI director Alok Verma in this case. So there were allegations and cross allegations from both the sides. Now the order will come at 4 o'clock. Now it has to be seen that even the Patiala House Court takes the consideration of the Delhi High Court order, which has been given after the plea was filed by Rakesh Asthana and Devendra Kumar.
This is going to have an effect on that order as well. Let me go across. Munish, I want you to stay on with me. Let me also bring in Rahul Srivastav, National Affairs Editor, India Today, at this junction. Rahul, this is an interim breather of sorts for Rakesh Asthana. The fact remains that this dirty linen being washed in the courts, everything is now public, and it is only eroding the credibility of the CBI.
Ankit, what we can say is that perhaps that is one of the last recourse as far as the government is concerned, because what we can say is that the number two and the number one are logged in not only a battle, which is a turf war, but also ego battle, in which both are refusing to back down. One has lodged an FIR against the other, and the other has complained to the Cabinet Secretary and the CBC regarding corruption, disruption of cases and several others. Now, Ankit, what I would like to mention here, I was following what Munish was saying and has reported. The CBI lodged the case on the 15th of this month, and it has been some number of days, and it is now pleading before the courts that it wants to add certain sections as far as the FIR is concerned. Means it wants to amend the FIR. that is definitely raises a certain amount of suspicion that were proper sanctions taken as far as this FIR is concerned. Because in cases such as this, a proper sanction of the government needs to be taken. Now, if no sanctions have been taken, as far as the past sections which were charged, which were put up in the FIR, now, given the fact that new charges have to be added, will there be new sanctions involved? Is there something hasty about the FIR? Is a very query which can be raised. Were there proper due sanctions which were necessary, Rahul, for an FIR taken in this case? Is this case more inclining towards a bit of a mellified intent than being actually having a lot of evidence?
No, but the court in the same breath has also said that at this point of time, they can't say that there is any mellified intent. That is a course of investigation. They have asked Mr. Asthana to, in fact, produce all the documents under his charge for the investigating agency. But Rahul, if I turn the argument around, if they want to add more sections, does it mean that they want to, in fact, trouble Mr. Asthana much more? They want to bring in more stringent sections to trouble him further?
See, Ankit, an FIR can have several elements. Whatever is there in the public domain already is not being fully stated. The bribery angle did not go into the FIR. Bribery, and there was other charge regarding falsification of facts. All these elements, if the CBI does want to add now, means that was the FIR which was lodged on the 15th, was it an hasty affair? Now, if the CBI is saying that it had done due diligence before lodging the FIR, then why does it need to file an amended FIR? So these are a lot of technical nitty-gritties. The court in its wisdom, definitely it's saying that since the charges are grave, whatever have appeared in the current FIR, that is why it will not like to intervene. And that is why a certain amount of breather in terms till Monday has been provided, in which there is a virtual stay on the arrest of Mr. Asthana. But the fact remains that nobody till now, as far as the court is concerned, has ruled in favor of any one of them. And I think is a real take from the court proceedings.
As of now, it's all open as far as this war goes. Rahul Srivastava, thank you so much for joining us with all those details.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.